प्रवीरदा, शुड वी स्टार्ट?
आई थिंक सो, बिकॉज अदरवाइज ना इट विल बिकम
हो गया.
ओके, सो विश्वजीत एंड प्रवीरदा, इट्स ऑल योर्स.
ओके, सो गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीबॉडी.
गुड आफ्टरनून.
आई एम डॉक्टर विश्वजीत सेन. आई एम फ्रॉम 1975 बैच. आई टुडेज डिस्कशन, द स्पीकर विल बी Dr. Praveer Bijoy Kaur. I know him since my school days. He passed out from Vidyapeeth in the year 1973. And since then, he did his undergraduate MBBS from the prestigious R.G. Kaur Medical College in Kolkata in 1980. And after finishing his house job and internship, he completed his post-graduation NS, General Surgery, from SSKM Hospital of Calcutta University. And since then, he has been practicing surgery in and around Kolkata, has been a visiting consultant in many institutions. He was the ex-chief of surgical oncology in the ESI hospitals from 2004 to 2017. HOD of Surgical Oncology, Barasat Cancer Center. Presently, he is practicing basically oncosurgery. He is a consultant oncosurgeon and is a visiting consultant in MRI Hospital, Apollo Cancer Institute, and Desun Hospital, Kolkata. He is a life member of many professional bodies related to surgery, and was one of the founder member of the Oncological Society of Bengal. He is currently a governing council member of the Association of Surgeons of India and secretary to the Oncology Society of Bengal. He has been a past president of many of these societies. He has a lot of publications in national and international journals related to oncology. He was also a merit scholar during his school days and also during his college days. He has been participating in many forums, both in India and abroad, and given many lectures. He has organized a lot of conferences, and he is into a lot of social work, particularly in cancer detection and awareness camps in various parts of West Bengal and in Bangladesh. With this short introduction, I hand over the mic to Dr. P.B. Kaur so that he can start this 14th Prakthani Adda session on oncology. Thank you.
Thank you, Vishwajit, for this elaborate introduction of mine. At the very outset, I must thank the Vidyapeeth Prakthani executive members and the planners of Prakthani Adda session. I say Ritesh very active, but he remains silent in all the programs. But he and Rahul are the most dynamic persons in continuing this program, what I realized. But they remain silent. We can't see Rahul even in the video also. Anyway, I thank all of you, and I wish Vidyapeeth Prakthani to continue such program so that the bondage becomes more strong. And gradually, we can introduce more and more members in our forum. So today, to start with, I'd like to say a few words, because this is an Adda session, not a professional official lecture forum. So I'll share with you, I'd like to share with you some of my memories of Vidyapeeth, then Vidyapeeth Prakthani, and I would like to introduce myself, because many of you are not aware of me, because you were somebody or 15, 20, 30, 40 years junior to me. And actually, I thought I'd say a few words about me also. So without wasting time, I'm trying to share the screen and then I'll start. Yeah, hope this is visible and audible. Am I audible?
Yes, yes, yes.
And visible, yes, also. Yes.
Yes, yes.
Now Ma Durga is visible.
So at the very outset, I offer my Shubha Vijaya and festive greetings to all of you. This is how we have been celebrating Durga Puja for last 2 years. So this is a photograph where you can see it is in front of the teacher's quarter. This is Brotoda, Vidudda, this is Vidudda, this is Kalida. This is the black and white photograph. So you can imagine that that was in the era of 70s and 80s. This is again a photograph when I, along with my, this is me.
Not audible.
Yeah, audible?
Yeah, yeah, now audible. Yeah.
This is Ashok Da standing in front of Turyananda Dham. These are my, this is Pradeep Ashe, of whom I was discussing a few minutes back. This is me, my wife, and we have been in Vidyapit. This is Nandan Pahar. This was during the formation of Vidyapit Praktoni in the year 1889. This was the Vani Bhavan. That is the school building, which was only double storied on the backside and absolutely single storied building. This is the D team. Ashok Da in front of prayer hall. This is the program held at the gymnasium, which was open at that time. The facing was, the dais was on the Vivekananda statue, what we see today. So reverse has been made after the renovation of the gymnasium. This is Swami Pavananda Maharaj, Shambhu Maharaj. This is Kanai Maharaj. This is Swami Lokeshwarananda, Swami Shuitananda. And this is Hiralal Maharaj of the famous garden area. Sorry. So this is again after our cricket match. Here is me after the cricket match between the students and the teachers. 1990. This is 1990. So this is Shambhu Maharaj and Shuitananda Maharaj. This is Pradeep Da, this is Alok Da, and this is Dr. Gautam Pal. He has expired a few years back. This is in front of the prayer hall. Swami Lokeshwarananda Maharaj sitting with Shuitananda Maharaj and Shambhu Maharaj on both sides. These were the young kids at that time. Now they all have crossed 60. Virabhadra and many others are there. This is the cup I always cherish. Best sportsman that I received in 1972. Best sportsman, my name is inscribed there. These are the reunions that are held in Kolkata. They are all senior members. Most of them are no longer today. This is our batchmates, probably 7-8 years back. This is in Vidyapit reunion, registration being done. This is Vinay Shubhiki with Komal Dotto, Raja and others during one of the conferences. This is again 2009 or 8, I don't remember. The Swami Sarvogyananda Maharaj was the secretary at that time. This was in the stadium hall. And this is the GB meeting in the new annex. Shoidesta was the president at that time, Rahul Vishwas, who is no more with us. And this is our back, sorry. This is our batch who attended at that time. This is me. I was also attending a pre-clinic. And once we could not go there, we arranged a reunion at my house with their family members. So we have been with Vidyapit also. They are my children. 2016 photograph. This is 2019 photograph. And this is me in an international cancer conference in Delhi.
Prabirda, I could see your London photograph with Sherlock Holmes. My office was very near to the place.
Yes. It was in front of Sherlock Holmes. Baker Street, the mouth of Baker Street, there is a statue of Sherlock Holmes.
Yeah, so my office was like 300-400 meters from there. So sometimes I used to go for lunch there.
Oh, very good. If I knew that you were there, then I could have met you. So this is Cancer Awareness Program and Felicitation going on. This is in a picture of Bangladesh. This is the cancer conference which I organize almost every year. This is a conference organized by me. And here is the souvenir publication. And this is Mr. Jatin Shah. Many of you might be knowing him. He is the dawn of head and neck surgery in the world. He was earlier in the MSKCC, New York, with me a few years back when he came to Kolkata. So these are the names I have mentioned here. You have to guess what is common among them. And I'm sure you know what is common among them, because all these persons died a few years back. They all suffered from cancers. So they are all rich people. They are all influential people. But even then, they died of cancer. So my topic today is to know how to tackle cancer. Cancer is a very complicated subject and a dangerous disease. Many people die of cancer, and until few years back, people used to say cancer has no answer. But for the last 35 years, me and along with others have been relentlessly trying to convince the people that cancer has answers. Cancers are dangerous, not all stages are dangerous. So if you have a cancer, how can you tackle that? By money, because you are an industrialist or you have very big connections, you know very famous cancer hospitals are going abroad. These are the options to you when you suffer, you or your family member suffers from cancer. But unfortunately, the answer is none of the above. Only answer is with knowledge about cancer and awareness, we can survive, we can fight against cancer. So my whole topic is centered around awareness of cancer. And I'm sure you will be will gain some knowledge after this discussion. And if one person is benefited, I would think my venture is successful. So what cancer comes from the word carcinos. Carcinos is a Greek word. And as it is compared with, cancers are compared with crabs. And it is known since the dawn of civilization. All caste, age, and religion, people are affected. There is no definite infection like tuberculosis or anything. So there is no fixed treatment and no fixed positive agent. And it can affect all organs of the body. This is the photograph of a mummy of early Egyptian civilization, 3000 BC, say roughly 5000 years from now. They also state that there was cancer in that time. Also, Edwin Peters wrote in his description that cancer was there in Egyptian civilization also. This is the worldwide incidence. This is the statistics taken from WHO, IARC, International Association for Research on Cancer. You see the Western Europe, Australia, having more deep, they have more cancers. These are the countries having more blue means they are having more cancers than a poor country like ours, the African countries, and the relatively poor country like Mexico. But on the other side, you can see the mortality. The people having so blue, they are not so red in case of mortality. Means they can tackle cancer by their own methods. They have proper treatment centers, diagnostic centers. People are aware. Mm-hmm. So even if they are having cancers, they don't die so frequently. Mm-hmm. This is the graph showing, the blue line shows the incidence of cancer and the red line shows the incidence of mortality. You can see the developed world, the cancer is so high, but mortality is not that high. If compared to our country, say Southeast Asia, incidence is so much and mortality almost 60%. So that is why we have to be aware about how to tackle cancer. This is the 2020 statistics, which showed that almost 19 crore people in the world suffered from cancer, of which almost 10 crore people died. Such is the severity of the disease. Commonest disease till few years back was lung cancer in the world, but today breast cancer is the highest incidence, female breast cancer throughout the world. As far as death is concerned, cancer causes nearly 12% of all death throughout the world. Out of 100 deaths, 12 were attributed to cancer. In the developed countries, almost 21% die of cancer, but in the underdeveloped countries, 9.5% die of cancer. This does not mean that we are surviving cancer. This means most of our other patients are dying of diseases like cholera, tuberculosis, dengue, etc. So cancer is almost 9%. This is about India. Lung is still little bit higher in India, little bit higher than breast cancer. But the death of lung cancer is highest in India because of poor detection, late detection, poor treatment, etc. So in India, the statistics goes like this. Every 8 minutes, one woman is dying of cervical cancer. For every two women who are diagnosed with breast cancer, one woman is dying. And tobacco-related death is more than 3,500 persons per day in India. So this is the mortality statistics in India. So now I go into the... What is cancer? Cancer is a general term. It is not a fixed disease. It is a group of diseases which are characterized by uncontrolled growth and spread of abnormal cells, which are cancer cells, which forms tumors and invade and destroy a surrounding body. Sometimes there may not be tumors, like say blood cancer. There is no tumor, but they grow exponentially. And when there is a distant spread, we call it a metastasis. Cancer cells are different from the normal cells. We know the normal cells, they divide. Mitosis is the normal cell division, 2 to 4, 4 to 8, 8 to 16. But in cancer, it grows exponentially. You cannot control that. So what are the causes of causative factors? The most common causative factor is tobacco. Next is alcohol, some virus, and chronic irritation also causes. I'll show you lifestyle changes like addiction, marriage, childbirth, pollution, bowel habits, etc. cause cancer. Diet and food habits are also important. Some hormones may cause cancer. There are very few cancers which are hereditary, and the effect of radiotherapy also causes cancers. So these are the causative agents. Only smoking is dangerous. Smoking with alcohol is more dangerous because they have a synergistic effect. These are the very common pictures you see all throughout India. And this is how our lifestyle goes. And this is how cancer occurs from Chinese in the heartland of India, say Bihar, UP, even in Bengal, people are having Chinese cancer. I have got a few hundred such photographs, only few are being shown here. How Khoini cancer can teeth. So these are the teeth, irregular teeth, which causes cancer of the tongue, and the ill-fitted dentures also can cause cancers. Fast food, grilled food, processed meat, these are all dangerous for cancer. Tinned fish, dry fish, air pollution, very important. It not only causes cancer, but also causes some other diseases also in the lungs. You can see this is the morning picture of Delhi. This is the office hours in Delhi. So these are the sources of air pollution, including Caracas biomass burning that is happening in you have taken during the lockdown period. This is how India Gate looks like. In the lockdown, first 1 month after lockdown, India Gate was looking like this. But usually it looks like this throughout the year. So this is the amount of pollution we are facing every day. So if there is a cancer, how does it spread? It spread directly from one organ to the other or through the lymphatics. It can go to other distant areas through blood, as also there is a called iatrogenic. Iatrogenic is caused by the physician during operation. If you are not careful, you can spread cancer. Cancers are named, many cancers are named, the tumor that are arise from the epithelial tissue are called carcinomas, that arise from connective tissue are called sarcomas, some muscle tissues are called sarcomas, nerve tissues like glioma, neurovirus, all these things. So once you find a biopsy report showing adenocarcinoma or a soft tissue sarcoma, you will be knowing what is the cause of origin of the disease. Common cancers in India, up to 20 years of age, these are the common cancers, of which leukemia and bone tumors are very common. In the adult and middle age, soft tissue sarcoma, testes, ovary, thyroid, etc. In the elderly age group, breast, prostate, and bladder, uterus, larynx. These are the common cancers in the elderly age group. The common cancers are head neck cancers, cervix, breast, lungs, stomach, colon, rectum, prostate. These are the 8 common cancers in India. And now the question is, when to consult a doctor? How do I know that if I have a cancer or not? So you have to consult a doctor. Initially, you go to the family physician or any physician who is nearby. Then if surgeon is available or you get a cancer specialist, cancer hospital, you can go to that place also. Any thickening or lump in the breast or any other part of the body which has developed and still it is increasing in size. Any changes in the bowel or bladder habit? Say early morning you are having normal bladder bowel habit, but suddenly you find every day early morning you get the call and you have to get up early in the morning and go to a stool. So you have to think there is some changes. So you have to be serious about that. If there is a change in the wart or mole that was there in your face or any part of the body, a black mole in the face is sometimes say beauty spot. And this beauty spot often turned malignant. Any sore that does not heal, a sore that is, normally a sore heals in 7 to 10 days time, but if it is there for months together, you have to be very serious. Any cough or hoarseness of the voice, or any unexplained body weight changes, body weight either sudden rise of body weight or the sudden fall of body weight, you are losing 6 to 8 kgs every month, you have to think seriously whether it is cancer or not. Any bleeding from any part of the body. So these are the 8 symptoms that I have mentioned above, and you have to consider consulting a doctor if you have any of these symptoms. So when you go to a doctor, what does he do? He examines you and then asks you to undergo certain tests. It starts from the test for confirmation of the diagnosis, test for assessment of the spread, and test for treatment planning. So once you go to a doctor, if he is a knowledgeable doctor, if he knows about the subject, he will ask you to do the number one tests. Then if he finds this is cancer, he will refer you to a cancer specialist who will do all these tests and then decide about the treatment planning. So these are the tests commonly done to anybody who goes to a doctor with a suspicion of cancer. Most of them are laboratory tests to start with. And of these, blood, sugar, blood, stool, urine, etc., T1 markers, the blood study, then fine needle aspiration, cytology, or a biopsy. Vishwajit knows very well, and people like Vishwajit are helping us in diagnosing these cases. These are the laboratory works, and these are the most important and initial investigation which will help us to come to a conclusion that this is cancer. And sometimes you have to undertake few imaging investigations, say mammography for breast, ultrasonography for abdominal or intra-abdominal lesion, ERCP for a jaundice patient, or bronchoscopy or laryngoscopy, or this endoscopy we have to do. So after doing all these tests, we can know that patient is having a cancer. Then we see whether the disease is restricted to that organ or not, or it goes to other investigation like CT scan, MRI, PET scan, PET CT fusion, etc., etc. These are done once your diagnosis is confirmed. Then for the planning of treatment, certain investigations has to be done. For a surgical procedure, we have to do coagulation profile, electrolytes, sugar, renal function, then serology. Then for anesthetic fitness, you have to do ECG echocardiography. For a COVID-19 these days, we have to exclude COVID-19 before admitting you. So naturally, these are the tests has to be done when you are subjected for treatment. I'm telling all these things because you will be aware that what has happened to my patient, my close relative who is suffering from cancer, you will be knowing that these tests you have to take so that you don't misunderstand the hospital or the doctor. These are the certain investigations through which there is a plain X-ray, chest X-ray. You can see there are multiple metastases. There is a solitary tumor in the lung. Ultrasonography can tell you some endoscopic ultrasonographic LDO rectal cancer or not. Then CT scan, various parts of the body you can do CT scan, ovarian cancer, liver metastasis, thyroid cancer. This is a colon cancer you can know from CT scan. MRI has to be done to see the tumor mostly in the peripheral region. Then we do isotope bone scan, whole body. We do PET CT scan. These are costly investigations, maybe 20-25,000 rupees, but these are investigations to be done to see whether the patient is treatable or not. ERCP for a jaundice patient. These are mammograms done for breast cancers. Isotope scan for thyroid and other diseases. CT guided FNSE or direct FNSE. A barium X-ray and endoscopy to see the contents inside the stomach, esophagus. And based on this, we do some staging of the cancer. Once it is diagnosed, we have to see whether it is confined to the organ of origin or it has gone to other areas. What is the histology? And based on that, we say it is an early stage or intermediate stage or late stage. If it is early stage, we call it stage 1 and stage 2. Okay, these are early stage. And the treatment results are very good with stage 1 and 2A. And the treatment results are very bad with the advanced stage. But in the intermediate stage, which we get most of the patients in the intermediate stage, here you have to be very rational, you have to discuss properly with the patient and start your treatment, because these are the patients, some of them might be cured, some might not be cured. That's why we have to discuss a lot with the patients. So once it is early stage, our treatment, our planning is to cure the patient, so we do a curative treatment. But if it is an advanced stage, we know that patient is not going to be cured. So we don't ask them to spend a lot of money or move here and there, go to several hospitals or several doctors, because these are not going to help him. So the palliative treatment is intended to increase the survival time, delay his death, and improving the quality of life. These are the common treatment options available to us, surgery being the commonest. Almost 70-75% of cancer patients, they require some form of surgery for their treatment. Radiotherapy and chemotherapy are equally...
Dada, second. I would request every other participants to kindly mute themselves so that there is no disturbance, please.
Radiotherapy and chemotherapy, they are mostly applied as adjuvant, means along with surgery, say after surgery or after surgery or before surgery, you give. Then hormone treatment we have. Then recently a lot of targeted therapies have come. They are very costly, but even then they are helping a lot. A lot of patients are getting targeted therapy these days. We have vaccines, antibodies, and biological response modifiers. These are the options. But the first three, and then two, are commonly applied these days. So being a surgeon, surgery, you can say this is the mainstay of treatment in most all these major diseases. So majority of the patient of brain tumors, thyroid, parotids, head, neck, lungs, they are cured by surgery. Majority of them are cured if surgery is done properly, followed by radiotherapy or chemotherapy and or chemotherapy. Then radiotherapy. Radiotherapy comes next, and radiotherapy equally useful as that of chemotherapy. The radiotherapy may be from distance called external beam. If it is from nearby, then it is called brachytherapy, short radiotherapy. It can be intraoperative also. During operation, you put some tube and source of radiation and tell the patients to come, go to radiotherapy department after some days, and you start radiotherapy. It can be given either singly or in combination with chemotherapy. And most of the time, radiotherapy are adjuvant to surgery. And sometimes in cases which are inoperable cases, we cannot treat by surgery, then radiotherapy is also given. And in some recurrences, and radiotherapy has got different types of radiotherapy. Our radiotherapy colleagues, Shukdev is there, they will be able to tell you properly. IMRT, ICRT, these are common radiotherapy, variety of radiotherapy. Then chemotherapy. This is the treatment of cancer by chemicals. Some drugs are applied. This chemotherapy is useful as curative treatment for certain diseases, say leukemia or lymphoma, or a germ cell tumor, the young women having ovarian tumors. These tumors are very much sensitive to chemotherapy. But majority of the cancers, they require as adjuvant treatment. And this adjuvant treatment is after surgery or sometimes before surgery, either single drug or multiple drug. These are the common cancers where these things are applied and results are satisfactory. Only surgery, patient might not be cured, but with adjuvant radiotherapy, chemotherapy, patient might be cured. Sometimes you have to do palliative treatment for relieving obstruction of some food passage, stool, urine, bile, airway. And these are mostly done by surgical methods. Emptying, we can put a tube in the stomach, or from outside you can feed. These are the small procedures, but it improves the quality of life. Say there is an obstruction in the larynx. Once there is an obstruction in the larynx, so lower down entire airway is blocked, we can put a tube called tracheostomy and thus save the patient. Again, when there is an obstruction in the bile passage, you can do a stenting and do ERCP. Then also patients get some lease of life. In intestinal obstructions, say in the colon and ileum, we can do a colostomy or a ileostomy. In case of urinary obstruction, say suppose there is a kidney, there is an obstruction lower down in the bladder, whole of the ureter is obstructed. So either from outside or from this side, you can put tubes and they will drain the urine out. And this can be collected in a bag and kept in a pocket. It can be done in both sides also. These are called nephrostomy. I could not resist showing you some of the photographs of patients we come across in India. I have thousands of such photographs. Only few I have. I am showing you. This is an ovarian cancer. You can see the patient comes with a so big a lump, and then after operation, almost many of them are benefited by surgery. These are exposed areas of the body. Even then, the patient don't come to us. This gentleman having a tumor here for so long, X-ray shows bones are involved, so he had to undergo an amputation, below knee amputation. So this is unfortunate that people having tumors in their exposed areas of the body, but they don't come to the doctors in proper time. This is absolutely due to lack of awareness. These are some of the advanced breast cancers. You can see the big tumors bleeding almost every day, and patients are doing every day. They are carrying on their lives. And when they come to doctors, we find such advanced disease, and very few of them are benefited by various forms of treatments. See, these are the tumors, very exposed areas, everybody can see. Even then, the patients don't come at the proper time. They come after 6 months, 8 months, and even after 1 or 2 years. But there are certain tumors, even if they come in advanced stage, they are salvageable. We can do a very big surgery with a free flap, a big operation, a lot of cost involved, and these patients get 2-5 years extra life by surgery. This is one case where this gentleman having a cancer here in the lip and the angle of the mouth, and we had to resect the half of the mandible, resected, bilateral operation done. Then from the leg, we take bone and we have to do microvascular surgery. These are done by plastic surgeons. And we anastomose blood supply artery and vein. The bone is shaped like a mandible. And these are the old photograph, 2004. And this gentleman survived for almost 10, 12 years after the surgery. So these are expensive surgeries, but we can do give some help to them. So what is the overall survival? This is a rough estimate, not a true, it varies from organ to organ. The what is 5 year survival for esophagus is 15 year survival for breast, or a 30 year survival for thyroid. So it varies. But in general, patients who come in early stage, most of the patients survive for 80 to 90% patients survive for 5 years, 10 years, or even more. In stage two, relatively less. But in stage four, it is very dismal. Less than 30% patients can survive up to 5 years. This is not a correct picture, but this is a rough estimate I have shown. This is to highlight that if the patients come in the early stage, results are very good, and many patients can survive with minimum cost, less expense. But as the disease progresses to stage three and stage four, the results are poor, cost escalates, and ultimately the patient dies. What we say in Bengali, dhone prane mara jawa, that happens. So what is the key? If we have knowledge about all these things, I think we can help our relatives and our family members. The three factors: you have to prevent cancer, you have to do a screening and early detection. A screening and early detection, patient goes to the doctor, the treatment cost is very less, very early diagnosed, very small operation, minimum treatment cost, and patient survive, get a normal life. So we have to concentrate on these things mainly. Actually, throughout the world, it has been accepted that if a regular exercise, low calorie diet containing fibers, fruits, vegetables, avoiding a sedentary lifestyle, animal fat, and grilled meat, we can lessen the risk of developing cancer. And WHO says that 40% of the cancer deaths worldwide could be prevented with proper diet, exercise, and tobacco avoidance. So these three, if we follow, I think we can also help ourselves. Some pre-malignant conditions there in the body. Not all cancers come all of a sudden. Many tumors are there in the body, or many conditions are there in the body which are there for 10, 15, 20 years. We just go on neglecting them, and ultimately after 15, 20 years, they turn into cancer. So this is a leukoplakia of the oral cavity. Some of the people in the, say, in the oral cavity or penis or perineal region have got whitish skin, whitish mucous membrane. They just avoid. They don't care to go consult a doctor. They go on doing chewing, pan, tobacco, etc., etc. And gradually after 5, 7, 10, 15 years, they turn into cancers. Phimosis is a condition which is known in almost all families. All the children, most of the children at their 3, 4, 5 years of age, they have phimosis. If the parents are conscious, aware, they get this phimosis treated either medically or by surgery, and you can avoid a penis cancer in future. Because in phimosis, the skin is not retracted, which causes cancer. And as you know, the people of the Jews community, the Muslim community, they do the ritual phimosis operations, some in the within the first 7 days after birth or first year after birth. The Muslim population, they does it 7 to 10 days after birth. The Jews does within a year of birth. The Hindus and the Christians, they never do this ritual procedures. And that's why cancer of the penis is very common amongst the Christians and the Hindus. Sorry. Undescended testes, as you know, testes comes from inside the body. Many children are born with a testes in the groin. And if they go to the doctor, their scrotum remains empty, either vacant on one side or remain empty. If they consult a doctor, doctor will investigate and find the undescended testes. And these undescended testes should not be allowed to stay there for more than 2-3 years. If they remain there for up to the age of 8, 10, 12 years, these testes turn into cancer. There are polyps in the colons. Some children at the age of 10, 12 years, they come with bleeding from the rectum and they are diagnosed to have these polyps. And these polyps should be treated. Not all polyps are cancer. Few polyps are cancer. But if these polyps are allowed to stay there, they can turn into cancer. Ulcerative colitis, then cervical erosion. The people in the younger age group, say 20, 25, 30 years, many of them complain of erosion in the cervix, foul smelling cervix. And if they treat properly, it's okay. Otherwise, these cervical erosions can turn into cancers. Gallbladder calculi, gallbladder stones. Many patients with gallbladder stone, they just remain silent for 10, 15, 20 years. They don't bother. And these stones can cause gallbladder cancer. Some breast lumps. Similarly, long-standing tumors in the parotid, thyroid, and other part of the body, these can also become cancer. So you have to be a little bit aware. Any tumor in and around the body, if you see it is there for 5, 7, 10 years, you should immediately consult a doctor and get it treated. The premalignant conditions in the oral mucous membrane comes in whitish patch, reddish patch, the submucous fibrosis, one cannot open the mouth properly, the lichen planus and dysplasia. These are some of the conditions. If they are allowed to be there in the oral cavity for 5, 7, 10 years or more, then they can turn into cancers. So these things you can avoid. These are preventable cancers. Oral cavity cancers you can prevent. You take colored vegetables. Many people are, they think the snobby in character, they think these things are taken by the people of the lower economic status. So he should be always taking meat, fish and all these things, chickens. These vegetables, green vegetables, these carrots, these things, this broccoli, these cauliflowers, this what we call in Bengali is kumlo. These are very important in preventing cancers. And all of us should be aware that we should have all these things in our daily marketing. If you go for a marketing in anywhere in the world, you should market all these colored vegetables, this tomato. These colored vegetables contain a lot of antioxidants, lycopene, etc. Do physical exercise, outdoor physical exercise in any form. Play major games or do swimming, do running, cross-country race, do morning walks. You can see this person, many of you might be knowing, he is Anil Ambani. He used to walk run 20 kilometers every day in the morning until a few years back. I don't know what he is doing after he has declared himself insolvent. And second one after prevention is the early detection. And best way of early detection is the screening. But in our country, these facilities are not available everywhere, but most of the cancer centers are trying to have some facility for screening. And screening means a healthy individual should go to a doctor and get investigations to see if he has or if he or she has got any cancer, of which the breast cancer is very common in India. So self-breast examination is very common. And we always teach the female patients how to do a self-breast examination. For the women folk from the age of 12 to 50, 25, 30 years, we ask them to undergo these tests, pap cytology. Few genetic study has to be done. You know BRCA1, BRCA2, etc. Breast cancer, ovarian cancer, some of them are genetic, and some of these tests has to be done, tumor markers and test if required has to be done. So these are screening procedures. This is self-breast examination. We teach them, we have videos, we tell them how to do self-breast examination, both breast initial inspection, then palpation, then nipple areola, and every year they should have a doubtful cases examination from a doctor, and they will do self-breast examination every month, and that should be done after the period. The cervical cancer screening. Many women in our society are having cervical cancers. So screening should start by the age of 21 years. It should continue up to the age of 70 years. And we know the HPV virus is very much responsible for causing of cervical cancer. So we have to provide them HPV vaccines. There are a lot of HPV virus, more than 200 varieties. Only two cancers, they constitute more than 80% of the cervical cancers. So HPV 16 and 18, we have to exclude, and we have these days vaccines for HPV, Gardasil and Cervarix by two companies. We can give vaccine to almost all women from the age of 15 to 25 years. Many of our Vidyapeeth practitioners might have their children at the age of 15 to 25 years. So I think you should seriously consider HPV vaccines. HPV vaccines can prevent almost 80 to 90%, more than 95% are caused by HPV virus, of which HPV is this Gardasil and Cervarix 16 and 18 quadrivalent. You can prevent more than 80% of the cervix cancers with vaccines. Again, we have hepatitis vaccines. Hepatitis B and C can occur. These hepatitis B and C ultimately will lead to a cancer of the liver. So if we give hepatitis B and C vaccine, say from the age of say 20, 25 years, and they're not very costly and not very difficult. If you can do that, you can prevent a liver cancer. So what is the take-home message? Take-home message remains that awareness programs should be conducted, like Vidyapeeth Rakhtani. I encourage all organizations, the local clubs, hospitals, anywhere where I go, I encourage them to go for these awareness programs. And we urge government to introduce certain legislatures, a ban on tobacco, air pollution control, etc. Next, several times, because cancer, if detected in the early stage, almost 100%, if not 100%, 95% are curable. And 40% of the cancer deaths are preventable if you follow all these things. Screening is very helpful. Biopsy, FNSE should be done. They never cause any spread. And so naturally, many people are afraid of doing biopsies. And even an operation, they never cause spread of the disease. And radiotherapy result, self-breast examination, vaccines, and most importantly, we should avoid the unscientific methods of treatment. Unscientific, there are a lot of unscientific methods in India and poor countries. We should try to avoid. And do you know what is the similarity of this, all these patients? You have heard of their name, everybody knows. This Graham Pollock, Richie Beno, Geoffrey Boycott, Colin Powell, he was the extended. He died a few days back of some other disease. They are all cancer survivors. They all suffered from cancer. Monisha Koirala, Lisa Ray, Shwanika Mantas, breast cancer, Jubra Singh is a germ cell tumor. Then Hanif Ahmad, the liver cancer. Martina Navratilova suffered from breast cancer. This Boycott suffered from esophageal cancer. So all these patients, they have survived. So not that situation is so gloomy. Picture is not that gloomy. The thing is, these people, they consulted doctors and followed their advice. And they survived for 5, 10, 15, 20 years after that disease is diagnosed. So there is a difference between survival and death doesn't depend on your influence or money. It depends mostly on your consciousness and awareness. So please accept my best wishes. And thank you from this part of the world, the Bank of River Ganges, having the second Hooghly Bridge in the background, Vidyasagar Sethu. I am prepared to answer a few questions if asked for. Thank you.
Very nice, comprehensive talk and covered everything. Good.
And very informative.
So,
but Prabhirda, can I, with your permission, you are a senior person, can I just one comment?
Yeah, sure.
So you told the causes of cancer is like tobacco. So many things you have given. But I think they are the not exactly causes, because it lies within us. Unless I got the oncogene in my body, even the alcohol or the tobacco cannot. I don't have to dispel the tobacco cancer, but the real cause is my gene.
Actually,
in my body.
I deliberately omitted this chapter, because these are all detailed description and lot of controversies, lot of discussions involved, because basically cancer is a genetic disease.
Yes.
All cancers occur due to change in the genetic level.
My own body.
Yeah, in its own body. There are factors which are trying to cause cancers. There are certain factors in our body which are trying to avoid cancers, like the TAG4. The P53 gene trying to prevent cancer, while a proto-oncogene is trying to cause cancer. Yeah. So these things I intentionally deliberately omitted here, because most of our audience are lay people. They should not be confused with all these terms. When it is a professional discussion, medical forum, obviously we have to tell.
No, non-medical. Why I am raising? Because many of us are non-medical. They'll always argue that he has taken cancer, alcohol for the whole life, and he's not suffering. Or this person is taking tobacco for the last 30 years. So there only this point comes, that probably his body is different.
It is okay, but we cannot say this is in an open forum in the presence of non-medical persons that you carry on your life, your body will look after you. We cannot say like that. We have to avoid these things. Even after avoiding all these things, you might have cancer.
So, you are 100% correct. But I just want to say, because they have lay people, sometimes they argue. And one more thing, I also little different, that you say early detection cures cancer. That also is maybe not exactly 100% true, because even if we cure treat every cancer, 20 to 30% will not able to save them.
Rule. We have to set a rule. There will be 5-10% exception. Unless there is an exception, that is not a rule at all. Even if patient presents in early stage, some patients die because of other factors.
Early detection of all cancers will not cure them. Say 30% we can prevent, another 30-40% we can cure. But rest persons, there is no answer to at this stage of the medical science. I don't think answer is there. Still, they have to. We cannot save them. Some of the cancers. So that message has to also go to these the allied people who are not exactly medical people. That also message should go, that all, even if you treat everything, we may not be able to 100% eradication of cancer at this stage of the knowledge that is available to our medical science.
Okay, Sukhdev, let me clarify. See, Dr. Praveer Bijoy Kaur was very lucid in his presentation, so that the message goes to the people who are not doctors. When you are talking about the factors causing cancer, actually what he has mentioned are the predisposing factors.
So he has told causes.
No.
Positive factors.
Don't take it from the medical point of view. See,
I'm not taking from a medical point of view. I'm taking from a scientific point of view.
And,
scientists are educated. They'll say cause means cause. Cause means there will be an effect.
Alcohol
will cause the cancer in if I don't have the P54.
In medicine, Sukhdev, in medicine, there is nothing all or none.
Yes.
Okay. So let's forget. And the second thing which you were saying about, in cancer treatment, when we say cure, we are talking about disease-free survival. These are technical terms. And that can be discussed in technical forums. But a 5, 10, 15 years disease-free survival is almost cure, because many of these patients will die of other causes, for an accident or so many other causes. So that is cure. Obviously, nobody will be able to. It is not like an infective disease that you take a medicine and it will go away. I am dealing with a lot of early breast cancers in Delhi. And since the advent of mammography and ultrasound, I have hundreds of patients which I have diagnosed on biopsy, sub-centimeter lesions. Patient has come for routine because of awareness programs, and they are cancers actually. And they have all survived. They are absolutely happy. Nothing needs to be done. No chemotherapy, no radiotherapy. You just take it out surgically. So that is the message which should go into the public, that early detection is the only way that you can get rid of this ailment. Otherwise, by the time patient... if you look at the urban society, we do not see breast cancers in stage 4 nowadays. During our MBBS, we used to see. Dr. Kaur has showed so many pictures. But in the city life, we don't see. Why? Because some awareness is there. But in the rural areas, it is still not there. What to do? That is the health setup has to change.
When in my photographs, I think you have noticed, most of the advanced cases were photographed in 2003, 4, yeah. 5, 6. For last 10, 15 years, India has progressed a lot and awareness has developed.
Yeah.
We don't see such cases in last 5, 7 years.
So, can I? The doctors, I'm listening. My name is Arnab Sanyal. I left Vidyapeeth in 1969.
Yeah.
Arnab, I know you very much. You are junior, senior to us. You played cricket and fast bowler, correct. And are hockey player too. I remember you. You are a little thin figure. Very nice. You are from Delhi.
Yes, I'm from Delhi, but I live in England now.
Yeah.
I heard everything that's been said. It's very informative. I can underline the suggestion of early detection. I've been studying for a PhD in genetics, and one of the things that have improved over the years, if you go back 10, 15 years, cancer was a death certificate. Now cancer is not a death certificate because, as you quite correctly said, early detection is the key. Now, with the advent of modern medicine, there's also a lot of scientific research going on, and I'm sure you've heard of pre-implantation genetic diagnosis. These things can literally, if and when comes into the mainstream, can eradicate BRCA1 and BRCA2 breast cancers. So cancers, as you quite rightly say, the most important thing is early detection. And if that can be done, jobs for doctors like yourselves makes it easy. The extension of the life is at least 85%. And that is the key. And as you quite rightly say, in the urban areas, it's falling quite considerably in India. I don't know much statistics about India, but I can see from the rural areas, it's the question of education and perhaps making them aware as to what it is. But I totally understand what you're saying. And I'm encouraged that things are improving so much in India. That's it. Thank you.
Thank you, Arnobda.
Today in the early morning, there was a lecture in one session. One of the directors of National Cancer Control Bureau was delivering a lecture. I heard that. He has shown that in last 5 years, the scenario has changed a lot. Many people are coming in the early stage, in the breast cancer, cervix cancer, even lung cancers. What people used to come in so advanced stages 15, 20 years back are coming in relatively earlier stages, and they are better result.
So,
any other questions? We have time.
Probita, what about the hereditary factor?
Hereditary factor is there in few cancers like ovarian cancers, breast cancers, colon cancers. These three cancers has got some hereditary effect, but that effect is to the tune of 2-4%. Not that all patients having breast cancer will have their next generation breast cancers. No, 2-4% only. And that too can be determined most of the time these days with this study, genetic study, molecular biology study. And hereditary cancers, if patient is having a cancer in his family, say father or mother or grandmother having a cancer, then he should be more careful because he is a high risk patient, and he should undergo screening much earlier, say 15, 20 years of age. And they should be prepared to face any form of cancer. And so early diagnosis and early treatment, most of the time are benefited.
So, did Prabirda Ritesh here.
Yeah.
First of all, thanks very much for your time and for the great presentation. Here is a proposal. Is there a way at least the Kolkata-based alumni can have a screening at your place or the hospital you work for? we can do something. Say we will get them registered through Google Forms, say 10 or 15 of them. You give them some time and they come and get a screening for cancer. Is it possible?
Yeah, very much possible. Not in a systematic way because you don't have such system, but it can be organized very well. Right.
So we will take it up later on when you have time, yes, and we can plan for the welfare of the Vidyapeeth community, including their family.
Yeah, if there is anybody who is interested in knowing about oncology career in oncology, some doctors might be there, younger doctors. I don't know if they are present here or not. Some of them are interested to have oncology as their career, become a medical oncologist or a radiation oncologist, or even a surgeon. If they want, they can ask questions. I'll try to help them out.
Thank you, Dada.
So, SN Ojha has in the chat box, I'm seeing a question. Is there a mobile application for screening cancer?
Yeah, basically in India, in Hyderabad, Dr. Raghu, P. Raghuram, of the Krishna Institute of Medical Sciences, he's a surgeon. He has got a robust experience of doing screening programs in Hyderabad under the aegis of KIMS, Krishna Institute of Medical Sciences. 2 years back, not two, more than two, 3 years back, he had developed a mobile app, and Amitabh Bachchan launched that app, where he says that if you have that app, you put questions and you answer those queries, most of the times you will be benefited. So in India till today, one app has come up from Hyderabad, P. Raghuram.
Okay. So Ritesh, if there is no other question, I think we can end the session.
Yes, please. I will give it to you for the closing remarks, please. Thank you.
So thank you, Prabirda, for the lucid presentation. I hope the message regarding the detection of cancer and awareness has reached to all of us. So we will be meeting quite often on different subjects in the Praktani Adda. I think today there were slightly fewer people because of the change in timings, because initially it was 5 o'clock. Doesn't matter. We can, because these will be uploaded, I suppose, Ritesh. So we can have a nice time. Till then, all of you, please keep safe. We hope that we will overcome COVID-19 soon, and we will be able to meet physically in Vidyapeeth. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Pravita. Thank you, Vishwajit.
Thank you.
See you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Okay, bye.
I am from 1977 batch.
Okay.
What is your name?
SN Ojha.
Shekhar.
शेखर एकदम बदल गए सब लोग.
अरे तो तुम भी तो चेहरा बदल लिए, वो तो दाढ़ी वाढ़ी रखी हुई थी.
77.
अरे सोमनाथ का छोटा भाई है.
सोमनाथ का
छोटा भाई. टुडेस टॉपिक.
व्हेन डिड यू जॉइन? लाइक टू टेल. व्हेन डिड यू जॉइन शेखर?
आई जॉइंड इन 70
along with Somnath bhi 70.
Along with Somnath, yes.
Mere ko yaad hai Somnath ka chota bhai tha, mere ko yaad nahi aa raha. Somnath
yahi hai bhai, yahi hai Shekhar.
Nahi to Bokaro uska ghar kai baar gaya.
Bokaro mein, yes.
Ha Prabir da ki bolchile?
Ha bolchilam ekta point, amader Vidyapeeth er kichu lokjon ache ei profession er sathe.
Okay.
Kichu mane one of the profession is this insurance profession, and in cancer, we have insurance. For treatment of cancer, you can have insurance policy of up to 50 lakhs rupees. This has been introduced in India in various insurance companies have introduced in 2-3 years back. So I think if you can afford nothing much, annual cost is 5,000 to 10,000 rupees, and you can have cancer insurance, because if you have a cancer in the middle stage, say not early stage, then might be 10, 15, 20 lakhs has to be spent for cancer. And if you can afford, like Mediclaim, if you can afford to pay 5,000 or 7,000 rupees as premium, I think that is a good choice. And our Vidyapeeth, some of our juniors are also doing this insurance business. So you can, both will be benefited if you do some insurance for cancer.
Okay.
Okay. So
actually,
I
myself is in this insurance industry, as Pravit the talked about it. So there are two kinds of insurance products. One comes in under this health insurance, where even after detected on the first or second stage, you can get a policy. This policy comes from the company Star Health. And another in life insurance also, that's a protection plan. You can take a coverage of like 30 lakhs, 50 lakhs, something like that. जिसमें कि आपका डिटेक्शन होने में कंपनी से पैसा मिलेगा. तो इफ एनीबडी इज इंटरेस्टेड टू नो देन कैन कॉन्टेक्ट मी ऑल्सो. ओके, तो एक तो है आप पहले से ही इसका प्रोटेक्शन ले सकते हैं, और ऐसे भी हो सकता है कि अगर किसी का कैंसर ऑलरेडी डिटेक्ट हो गया ऑन द फर्स्ट स्टेज और इवन ऑन द सेकेंड स्टेज, ही और शी कैन ऑल्सो टेक अ पॉलिसी.
Samudra, very nice of you to share this. May I please request you to, you know, summarize the policies you have and with the links, and we can circulate it among our alumni batch representatives, and they in turn they can circulate it among their batch. So if someone needs their policy for their home or family, they can contact you directly, please.
Sure.
Thank you, so let's call it a day. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you, Dada. Thank you, everyone. And let's meet soon for the next shutdown.